Knowledge Network.
Offers a wide range of educational opportunities for everyone. The Knowledge Network has rapidly expanded its service to British Columbia.
Serving the province of British Columbia since 1981, this is Knowledge Network.
Hello and welcome to the opening round of the 2004 Reach for the Top National Finals with Ontario champs Leaside High facing off against, from Red Deer, Alberta, Lindsay Thurber Comprehensive. Let the games begin. Hello and welcome. I am your unforgiving taskmaster of a quizmaster, Daniel Richler. We're going to meet the teams personally later in the game, but right now we're going to jump right into some snappers. So are you both ready?
Sure.
But are you really ready?
Oh, yes.
All right. What is the number 400 in Roman numerals? Luke?
I-S-D.
That is not correct. Leaside?
C-D.
Tiberio?
C-D.
That's correct. The cities of Shiraz, Qom, Esfahan, and Tehran are in... Brian.
Iran.
That is right. In musical dynamics, what term indicates sudden emphasis or... Yes, Brian.
Subito.
No, or suddenly very loud. Brian.
Forte.
No, I would have accepted sforzando or forzando. What type of building is most likely to have a steeple? Brian.
Church.
Yes, of course. Here is a Who Am I question. The question is worth 40 points. If you guess the answer on the first clue, 10 points less with each succeeding clue until either team answers the question correctly. Clue A. I was a great military strategist who served his country well. They even erected a column named after me. Tyler.
Nelson.
I have to actually look ahead and see that you are right, sir, for 40 points. In a similar vein, a what word am I question. The objective of this question is to identify the missing word common to a series of quotations. Players identifying the word after the first quotation are awarded 40 points, after the second 30 points, and so forth. Quote A, from Joseph Addison, who lived from 1672 to 1719, a perfect is the noblest production of human nature. Yes, Luke.
Circle.
I'm afraid that is incorrect. I will read you another quote. Quote B from Thomas Carlyle. The blank of life is not so much what men suffer, but rather what they miss. Brian.
Meaning?
No. Can you give it a try, Kelly?
Idea?
No. I'll give you a third quote from F. Scott Fitzgerald. This from the crack up. Show me a hero, and I will write you a... Kelly.
Comedy?
That is not correct. Leaside. Tiberio.
Tragedy.
That is the answer.
Oh.
Very good. Here is an open question worth 30 points in total. The theme is world religion. What ascetic Christian sect lived as hermits atop stone columns and were known as pillar saints? Luke.
Puritans.
No.
What?
Can you... Lisa.
Flagellants?
No, the answer is Stylites. What former title was given to the secular leaders who followed Muhammad as leaders of... Jeff.
Ayatollahs?
No, as leaders of Islam. Lisa. Tyler.
Caliph?
That's correct. Mahariva was the founder of what religion, an offshoot of Hinduism, to whom all animal... Tyler.
Sikhism?
No, to whom all animal life is sacrosanct.
Maybe good.
No.
No, Lindsay Thurber, the answer is Jainism. All right, here is an open question, 30 points in total. The theme is poetry. Come live with me and be my love. I am quoting here. And we will all the pleasures prove. These are lines from The Passionate Shepherd. Yes, Kelly?
John Donne?
No. The Passionate Shepherd to His Love, written by whom? Leaside.
Eliot Keith.
Brian.
Keats.
No, the answer is Christopher Marlowe. Oh. Come with me and be my love, and we will some new pleasures prove. Our lines from The Bait, written by whom?
Hmm.
Yes, Kelly.
Is that John Donne?
That is John Donne. Very well done. Very well done. What does the word prove mean in both of those poems? Yes, Daryl.
Show?
No. Can you give it a try, Lindsay Thurber? Ryan?
Find?
The answer is try. The theme of the next open question, worth 40 points in total, is mathematics. In how many different ways can seven people be seated on a bench if John must always be seated in the center? Yes, Luke?
35?
No. Can you give it a go, Leaside? Brian?
30.
There are actually 720 ways. What is the product of three consecutive even numbers, the smallest of which is 8? Daryl.
412?
No. 8 times 12. Brian.
30.
Now the answer is 960. In the area of trigonometric functions, what is the cosine of 450 degrees? Luke.
10.
No, I'm afraid not. Tiberio.
Root 3 over 2?
The answer is 0. What is the square root of 9 to the third power? Yes, Brian.
27.
That's correct. Here's an open question. Ologies is the theme, 30 points in total. The origin and history of words is known. Brian.
Entomology.
I'm sorry?
No.
I'm afraid that was wrong. Can you please try a little bit further? Ryan.
Etymology.
Etymology. Entomology is bugs. Yeah. What is the science that studies the whole universe, its origin, its nature, its size? Tiberium.
Cosmology.
That is correct. What do we call the branch of mathematics that studies geometrical objects? Tiberium.
Topology.
That is also correct. Here's an open question, 30 points in total. English prime ministers. Which British prime minister was assassinated? Tyler.
Percival.
That is right, Spencer Percival. What New Brunswick-born politician became... Yes, Tyler.
Law.
That is right. Is that... Now, the judges, he gave the final name, but it's, of course, Andrew Bonner Law. Okay. What cunning English statesman prime minister during the Crimean War... Yes, Tyler.
Aberdeen.
No, was cited in the grounds for a scandalous divorce case when he was 78 years old. The answer is Lord Palmerston. Here we have an open question. Works of art. Given a famous painting's title, name the painter. 1. The Garden of Earthly Delights. Kelly.
Blake.
No.
No.
Leaside. Yes, Tyler.
Hieronymus Bosch.
That's the one. Nude descending a staircase. Kelly.
Oh my God, where is it? Oh, no.
No. Leaside. Brian?
Rembrandt.
No, it's Marcel Duchamp.
That's it.
She knew it, but she couldn't find it. Girl with a pearl earring. Tyler.
Vermeer.
That's right. Sunday afternoon on the island of La Grande Jatte.
Oh.
Kelly.
Monet.
No.
Oh.
Lisa. Brian.
Rembrandt.
No, she was much closer. Georges Seurat.
He was an impressionist.
Exactly. All right, open question for 40 points in total. Canadian history. Which Canadian province was originally divided up amongst landowners by a lottery? Yes, Luke Tyler.
Alberta?
No, can you give it a try, Lindsay Thurber? Luke.
Quebec.
Prince Edward Island. In what year did the Canadian government introduce the income tax as a so-called... Tyler.
1917?
That is right, temporary wartime measure. What petition was circulated by Tories in 1849 urging that Canada join the United States? Luke.
The Union petition.
No. Brian.
United States petition.
The Annexation Manifesto is the answer. Which future Canadian Prime Minister signed the Annexation Manifesto? Jeff.
Mackenzie.
That is not right.
Future Conservative topic.
He was a future Prime Minister.
So the answer, I'm afraid your buzzer was just too late. It's Sir John Abbott. Here's an open question with scientists as the theme, 30 points in total. Who was awarded the Nobel Prize in Chemistry in 1960? Brian.
Curie.
No. For the development of the atomic time clock, which determined geological age by measuring the amount of radioactive carbon-14 in organic substances. It's all yours, Lindsay Thurber. Well, it was. William Frank Libby
is the answer.
Who developed the modern system of chemical symbols and prepared a table of atomic weights? Yes, Luke.
Mendeleev?
No. Leaside. To bury you.
Jonathan Lothar Meyer?
No, it was Baron Jons Jakob Berzelius. And who proposed the third law of thermodynamics? Brian.
Newton?
No, that's not right. I'm afraid it was Walter Nernst. And finally, we have a 20-point special taking us to the end of this round, literature. What were two of the three full novels completed by Franz Kafka by the time of his death? Tyler.
Metamorphosis and the Fly?
I'm afraid not. Can you give it a try? I would have accepted any of America, The Trial, or The Castle. And that brings us to the end of the round with 180 points for Leaside and 20 points for Lindsay Thurber. And welcome back with the score confirmed by the judges at Lindsay Thurber with 20 points and Leaside High of Ontario with 180. And this is the point where I introduce you to at least one of the people on the team.
Hello.
How do you do? You are the team captain, yes, Brian?
Yep. Yeah. I'm fine, thanks. Yourself?
Yeah, now, forgive me for being a sensitive Torontonian, but why do you love New York?
Oh, well, actually, this is a gift from a friend who was just in New York, Christopher Ritzo. Hello. And he wanted me to wear it, so.
I see, okay. Well, fine. We'll find out more about your passions later, but I'm going to chill you out for now. What is Rock and Roll Against Racism, Jeff?
Rocking on Against Racism. It's a concert that was put on by our Students and Teachers Opposing Prejudice group at our school. It was a great concert, lots of fun at the Red Deer College.
Very
in
good.
Fact, our own Kelly designed this logo.
Neat. Let's go right into some questions for you all. This is an assigned question worth 80 points on oceans and seas. This assigned question is one in which each member of each team is assigned a 10-point question. If you miss your question, then your counterpart on the opposing team will have a chance at it for 10 points. And so here we go. Team A. The Timor Sea separates the island of Timor from what country, Brian?
Indonesia?
No, so I give it over to Jeff.
Papua New Guinea?
No, the answer is Australia. And to bury you, what body of water was named by Magellan from the Portuguese for calm and serene? I have to give it to Luke.
The Pacific Ocean.
You are absolutely right. And Daryl, the Gulfs of Bothnia and Finland are part of what sea?
Black Sea.
That's not right. Kelly?
Adriatic.
The Baltic Sea is the answer. And Tyler? Of the Aegean, Adriatic, Ionian, and Tyrrhenian seas, which is the only one that does not border on Italy?
Aegean.
That is correct. Very good. Team B, for 40 points. What is the world's most heavily trafficked ocean?
The Indian.
That is not correct. Brian.
The Atlantic.
The Atlantic is right. Luke, the Dardanelles connect the Aegean Sea to what other sea?
The Black Sea.
That's right. Stop. Kelly, what freshwater inland sea is actually classified by scientists as the world's largest lake?
The Baltic Sea.
Ping, I'm afraid. Daryl.
The Caspian Sea.
That is the answer. And Ryan, what is the name of the sea off the coast of Newfoundland? I guess it's awfully far from Red Deer. What is the answer?
The Grand Banks?
No! Oh, the Labrador Sea is the answer. Okay, here we have an audio question. And Southern music is the general timbre of it, so tune your ears to this. The question is, Andre... Yep. Oh, Jeff. Hello.
I said, I buzzed earlier, Outcast.
That is the answer, yes. Andre 3000 and Big Boy are the duo. Which civil rights activist launched a lawsuit against Outkast for using... Brian.
Rosa Parks.
That's right, for using her name on one of their songs without permission. And here we have a second tune.
Well, I wish I was a
All right, Jeff, you press the button. I can't ask the question. I just have to hear your answer.
All right, let's say B.B. King.
Well, no, that is incorrect, so I will give Leaside the question. This Muddy Waters song inspired the name of what English band, the longest-running act in rock and roll? Brian.
The Rolling Stones.
That is correct. Very good. In which state did Alan Lomax first record Muddy Waters for the Library of Congress? The state also gives its name to this style of blues. Yes, Tyler.
Louisiana?
No. Brian.
Mississippi.
That's right. Mississippi Delta Blues. Here's a relay question for 50 points in total. It's on abbreviations. Now, these are directed to one team at a time. Consultation is permitted. I'll ask a first question, and if you respond correctly, I'll give you a second, and so on. But if at any time you respond incorrectly, the relay will end, and no additional questions will be coming from me. All right, first three questions are worth 10 points, the final for 20 for a grand total of 50. And here it is. What does each of the following abbreviations mean? Not all of the abbreviations are in English, but give the English full name regardless. You may have seen this during hockey games up to 1991, CCCP. Tyler.
Union of Soviet Socialist Republics.
That's right. A type of doctor, DVM. Brian.
Doctor of Venereal Medicine.
No, the judges don't like that. It's so that's it for that one. The answer is Doctor of Veterinary Medicine. Over to Team B. An Armed Forces Expression, AWOL. Ryan.
Absent without leave.
Yes, that's good. Or absent without official leave is another. Okay. In medicine, EKG.
Electrocardiogram.
Yes, Jeff.
Electrocardiogram.
That's right. You could have said ECG as well, or I could have. In the shipment of goods, FOB.
Oh.
Overboard?
Sure.
What overboard?
Look.
Foreign overboard.
No, it's free on board or freight. On board. And that is that for that.
We gained some on them.
Here's a list question for a total of 50 points. Up to five answers will be accepted for this. The team that buzzes in has the first opportunity to give an answer for 10 points, and then the opposing team will be allowed a chance to respond also for 10. We'll continue alternating between the teams until one of you gives either an incorrect answer or gives an answer that's already been answered. And we'll do that until the maximum number of responses to the question are reached. Name five players who, between 1995 and 2003, won the NHL's Hart Trophy for most valuable player in the league. Luke.
Dominik Hasek.
I will take it, yes.
Jerome Iginla.
Darryl, yes, sorry?
Jerome Iginla.
Well, no, as a matter of fact. How about you, Lindsay Thurber? It's all yours. Pardon? Luke.
Joe Sakic.
Yes.
Red Wings Iserman.
Go. Here's another. Luke.
Steven Iserman.
No, I have to stop you right there. The others were Eric Lindros, Mario Lemieux, Chris Pronger, Jaromir Jagr, Jose Theodore, and Peter Forsberg.
Right. Who got it from Detroit?
Hockey fans, take note. All right. Chain snappers, worth a total of 60 points. At the beginning of a chess game, how many squares are not covered by playing pieces? Yes, Tiberio.
32.
That is correct. What is the Celsius equivalent of 32 degrees? Luke.
Zero.
That's right. What? Which culture originally developed the concept of zero? Tyler.
Arabic.
No, and the decimal position of numbering. Kelly.
The Greeks.
Hindu, or India. Okay. What name was given to the numerals of Hindu culture when they were first introduced? Tyler.
Arabic.
That's right. How many verb tenses are there in the Arabic language? Brian.
One.
That's not correct. Lindsay. Jeff.
Two.
That's right. In the title of the children's tale by Mordecai Richler, whom does Jacob Tutu meet? And Tyler.
The Hooded Fang.
That is right, and that is the end of the round. We're back in a moment with the score. with the score standing at 120 points for Lindsay Thurber and 270 points for Leaside High. It's very well done. Before we continue the match, I am required to ask you a couple of other questions. For Leaside, how far outside of Toronto is that? Because I want to pursue this Toronto theme for a moment.
It's actually in Toronto.
It's actually in Toronto. It's That's for the viewers from across the land.
And Eglinton.
Very good. So now, what is your theory, guys? Why do you think Toronto is the most hated city in the country?
Just because we're the best?
Uh-huh.
Oh, come on!
Darn it. And you guys, your name, Lindsay Thurber, got me thinking about Mean Girls, you know, with Lindsay Lohan. There are very few females who play and reach for the top, and I wanted to know why you think that's so.
I don't know. Maybe it's just because... Maybe girls don't think it's cool or ever, it's too geeky, and they think that,
right.
You know.
Would the Mean Girls approve?
It's a big old nerd fest.
Yeah.
Oh, you think so?
We'd just like to say something really quick. I know it'll be late by the time this taping's done, but go Flames, go!
Yeah!
Have you got the score in there? Have you got your BlackBerry on or what?
No. Game doesn't start till later tonight.
All right, well, here's a shootout question for a total of 40 points. The questions are open to both teams, prompting consultation, absolutely forbidden. Once a player answers a question correctly, they may sit out the remaining questions in the shootout. As soon as all four players of a team have answered a question correctly, well, that team gets 40 points and the other team gets zero. Here we go. What is the name for a boat race that comes from even... Brian?
Data.
That's right. Maclean's magazine named what person Canadian of the Year 2000... Jeff?
Leacock?
No, 2003 for his dedication to helping people in Africa living with HIV/AIDS. Tyler?
Alex Trebek?
No, the answer is Stephen Lewis. What type of computer is considered to be between a microcomputer and a mainframe? Very old.
A mini computer?
That's right. To what group of class of society does the term hoi polloi refer? Yes, Tyler.
Common people?
That's correct. Or the majority. Scientists in India report that cases of malaria have declined significantly since they stocked creeks and ponds with what type of fish that love to eat mosquito larvae? Luke.
Pike.
No. Daryl.
Trout.
No, and Winnipeg, take note, guppies is the answer. What was the name of the Bronze Age civilization that was centrally located on the island of Crete? Luke.
Mycenae.
No. Leaside, anybody? Well, that would be you. Nope. Okay, the answer is Minoan. Marlowe is a narrator who turns up in several works by which Polish-born author? Neither. The answer is Joseph Conrad. What is the chemical symbol for curium? Luke.
C-E.
That's not right. Harold.
C-U.
No, C-M is the answer. The Way the Crow Flies is the latest novel from which Canadian author? Kelly.
Emery MacDonald.
That's right. Stand back, madam. In the Arab world, UAE stands for what? Jeff.
United Arab Emirates.
Correct. According to Noel Coward, what two groups go out in the midday sun? Yes, Luke.
Cowards and the Commoners?
No. It is Mad Dogs and Englishmen. I almost gave it away there. The statue of what beloved Hans Christian Andersen character can be found in Copenhagen's harbor? Yeah, Luke.
Thumbelina.
Thumbelina is wrong, I'm afraid. Well, that's it. There you go. Okay, the answer is the Little Mermaid. Okay, here is a team question now. 40 points in total. In this two-part team question, whichever team is first to answer correctly, the 10-point scramble question in part one is then eligible for the remaining 10-point questions in part two. So, part one. For 10 points, what is the largest city in Syria? Yes, Brian.
I guess Damascus.
That is correct. And so the remaining questions deal with Damascus. Dating from the second millennium BC, what empire first ruled Damascus?
Syria.
Tyler.
Assyria?
No, that is incorrect. And so the answer actually is Egypt. And now I'm required to ask the rest of the questions as open questions for both teams.
Nope.
That is not. Oh, they continue? I'm very sorry. What British adventurer and scholar worked with the Arabs to help the British take Damascus and Syria from the Turks in 1918? Tyler.
Lawrence of Arabia.
That's right. What river bisects the city of Damascus?
Tigris.
Ryan.
The Tigris.
No, the answer is the Barada River. And that is it for that question. Another team question for 40 points. It's another two-parter, just like the last one. So for 10 points, or pints as it says on my card here, what ancient poem by one Omar, son of Abraham the tent maker, is basically a collection of epigrammatic quatrains? Tyler.
1001 Nights?
No. Can you give it a try?
I don't know any whatsoever.
I don't know.
The answer is the Rubaiyat. And this, then, is the point where I ask you each questions all about the Rubaiyat, okay? To whom do we owe the masterful English translation of 101 of these quatrains published in 1859? Tyler.
Tennyson?
No. Jeff.
Pope.
Edward Fitzgerald. In what language was the Rubaiyat originally written? Luke.
Arabic.
No, can't take that. Ryan.
Sanskrit.
It's ancient Persian. Not Farsi, by the way. Given the next line of the following quotation, or give the next line, please, a book of verses underneath the bow. Brian.
Rembrandt.
No. Everybody, Luke.
Chandra.
A jug of wine, a loaf of bread, and thou. I think that's why somebody said it was worth 40 pints. All right. We now go straight to snappers as the game comes to a close. What is the formula for calculating the area of a triangle? Brian.
Half base times height.
Yes, that is right. In what museum is Lindbergh's aircraft? Yes, Brian.
The Smithsonian.
Correct. What is the name of the famous gambling casino found in Monaco? Tyler.
Monte Carlo.
Right. Margaret Macmillan won a Governor General's Award for which book for nonfiction? Time out, I'm afraid. You're a little slow there. The answer is Paris, 1919. For what purpose is graphite used in some? Tyler.
Lead. Writing materials.
For what purpose is graphite used in some nuclear reactors?
Containment.
Go. Jeff.
Containment of radioactivity?
Well, the answer is as a moderator, so the judges don't accept your answer there. After a 20-year career with the National Ballet of Canada, who? Brian.
Karen King.
No. Who will retire from his role as a principal male dancer at the conclusion of the 2000... Jeff.
Greg Harrison?
That's right. Right on the final buzzer. And we'll be back with the score.
Woohoo.
So at the end of this preliminary round of the national finals, Lindsay Thurber Comprehensive stands at 130 points, Leaside High School of Ontario with 320, making them the winner of this round. Congratulations. Well done. Very good. It's going to be a long 2 days. So you still stand a chance to do a shootout, right? You'll play another game, right? Yeah, you'll get a chance to go to the next round. You'll play the another loser, I think.
Yes, sir.